Inline grid entry of notes provides the ability to enter and display POV-based commentary directly in a grid via a note column or row when previewing a report in HTML. Begin by opening a report grid in edit mode. Insert a note column by right-clicking the column header and selecting Insert After and then Note. The note column segment is inserted into the grid. An icon identifies the column as a note column. Note, you cannot insert both note column and note row segments in the same grid. You can only insert either note columns or note rows in the same grid. Note also, if you insert the note segment before or after a data segment, then the note segment heading and member selections are inherited from the data segment. However, the system does not support note entry in formula or text segment intersections. If you insert the note segment before or after a formula or text segment, then the note segment heading and member selections will default to each dimension's top-level parent member. You can optionally change the note segment heading, as well as the column or row's width or height settings. I'll increase the column width and then change the note column header to comments. Note segments are typically associated with another column or row data segment selection, such as a scenario variance. Notice that the note column comments has the same member selection as the actual versus plan variance member in the adjacent data column, because the notes are intended to be for scenario variances in this case. You can use cell formatting to restrict or allow note entry for specific cells in a note segment. In this example, you do not want users to enter variance comments for total entities. Select the note cell for the total entities row and click Cell Properties. Set the Allow Note Input to No for the total entities note cell. Now let's confirm that Allow Note Input is set to Yes for the Children of Total Entities note cell. You can also use conditional formatting to restrict or allow note entry. Select the note cell for Children of Total Entities. Select Conditional Properties. Click Formats Text, and then click Add. Enter a descriptive name for the conditional format. The name must be unique for the grid. Select an attribute that you want to test for in the condition. In this example, you will test for the value of column C. Set a condition to disable note entry for any positive variances, because in this use case, you only require commentary for negative variances. Click OK to save the conditional format. The next step is to select an existing note template or create a new one. Select the Comments Note column. Select Column Properties. Under Note Properties, select Not Available to open the Note Templates window. You can either select an existing note template or create a new one. In this example, there are no existing note templates, so let's create a new one. Enter a name and an optional description for the note template. Optionally, you can set the character limit for notes. You also have the option to deselect editable to change the note format to read-only, which would disable note entry for all users of the note template. I'll leave this selected. As the report designer, you always have the option to edit this note template and disable note entry if needed. You can change the current data source. If you do not want to include one or more point of view dimensions in a note template and its related notes, you can remove the dimensions from the note template via the dimensions layout. Click POV Actions and then Change Dimensionality to display the dimension layout. You can drag dimensions to reorder them, or you can remove or add them from the point of view. You can enter and format placeholder text, which the note cell displays when users preview the report. Click OK to close and save the note template. In the Note Templates dialog, you can edit, delete, or refresh the selected note template. Select the note template in the Note Templates dialog to associate it with the report and click OK. Preview the report. Notice that the Edit icon is not displayed in the Note cell for Total Entities, where you set Allow Note Input to No. Notice also that the Edit icon is displayed for cells where Allow Note Input is set to Yes, but is not displayed for cells where the positive value condition is met. Click an Edit icon to open the note template. Here you can populate and format the note with an explanation of the negative variance. The note is displayed in the note cell. Save the report and navigate to Notes. The note has been entered into the system for the entity variance note template that you created earlier. The note is now available for display using the Notes text function. Check the description for links to related videos. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.